Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
My name is Prince Nwajere. I'm from Abia State. I live at 47 Wochi Road, opposite Elijiji Market. I came to OPM 2014, on December 2014. Before I came to OPM, I was going to a church. And that church I was going to, I've gone to that church for so many years. I was a minister in that church. I was a worker going to be a minister in that church. I was a Sunday school teacher and other things I was doing in that church.
I was doing everything. Sunday school teacher, usher, everything. But still, what happened?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now, I was supposed to ordain a minister in that church last year, 2015. But all of a sudden, something started going wrong. They introduced something that I didn't like into the church. So as that thing was going on, I started praying God. Say, God, please, direct me to where I will serve you. I don't want to serve God and go to hell. Direct me where I will serve you. But I never knew about OPM. So as that thing was going on, like close to a year, I was in the dream. I saw that day in my revelation. I was kneeling down on a big altar like this, and Daddy was hitting my head. I haven't seen Daddy before for my life. But he was hitting my head. Hitting my head because I've been walking and it seems like I'm not achieving anything. So he was hitting my head and saying, why will you be walking and you will not achieve something? He was hitting my head. So it was my wife that showed me Daddy on television one day that I came back from work. But because of the former church I go, they teach us not to listen to all this kind of pastors, that they are cultic people. So I just looked at that day on television and I removed my face. I walk out. I called my wife. I said, look at the revelation I had. My wife said, anyway, just pray about it. I prayed about it. I still continue going to that church. Second time again, I saw that day again in my revelation. I said, I want to go to OPM. As I came to OPM here on that December 2014, something happened. They were giving testimony and somebody came. A young man came to give testimony and he stood there to give testimony. As he was giving the testimony, Daddy came and crossed his hand on the person's shoulder. And as Daddy crossed his hand on the person's shoulder, Daddy now looked at the neck cloth, the collar of the young man's clothes was torn off. And Daddy said, you cannot go with this kind of clothes. Daddy directed him where they will dress him up. My wife turned and looked at me and I looked at my wife. I have worked with ministers, big men ministers. If you are talking to them, they will remove their face and keep their ear to listen to you. But Daddy came and embraced the guy. I told my wife, this one is a man of God. Hallelujah. So that thing from that day made me, I said, OPM is my church. When I left that church, so many ministers have called me. They've said a lot of things. I said, OPM. So many of them that have called me and said, even if you want to leave church, why is it OPM? I said, OPM. A minister called me and said, what did you see? Why should you leave to OPM? I said, I know the revelation I've seen about OPM. He said, I should forget about it.
The Lord said, speak and I will do it. I'm not the one doing it. It's God that's doing it. So God decides. He just says, I should speak. Because God is the final judge. If he allows such powers, I feel the walking for road and somebody just talked to me and I said, well, die now. They won't. I could use the drive though. Amen. But God has the final. Just say, speak and I will do it. And I program myself. Oh, when nature program into that dream. Continue back.
So since I came to OPM, God has been so faithful to us. Mm-hmm. Things has changed.
Oh.
You know, so me and my family, we were struggling to feed, but I was working.
I was working, but we are struggling to feed. Say, to feed aqua.
But as I came to OPM, God has renewed my life.
Oh.
So, let me not go too far. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I come here today. So when I left that church, that pastor of that church now called and announced on the altar that they should watch me from today, that they will see my end. So all of them, they were like looking at me to see my end. Mm-hmm. But instead of seeing my end, they are seeing me on top.
Egbede! 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 The greatest revenge against your enemy is what? Massive success.
Hallelujah.
Massive explosion.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, when they tried talking to me to come back, I said no. Then the pastor now gathered all the ministers and all the workers in the church and told them that I've left the truth and I've gone to Marine. That they should stay away from me. That if they see any member of that church close to me, that the person will go on suspension. So everybody in that church now stay away from me because I've gone to Marine, evil. But I thank God.
Oh!
Today, I come here to dedicate the shop I opened for my wife and the car that I bought for a business.
Pastor, look.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here. Amen.
My name is Joy Daniel. I located OPM on the 6th of January 2014. I came to OPM in search of a job.
I came to OPM in search of a job.
But God doubled the blessing.
Hey, Budu, God shall double your blessing today.
Yeah. Here in OPM, God blessed me with a job.
Bah, clap for Dr. Jesus.
Here in OPM, God blessed me with a husband. Not just a husband, the best husband in the whole world.
Give Jesus a clap offering. She came here looking for a job. Here in OPM, God gave her a job. Not just an ordinary job. Job in a bank.
In a bank.
God gave her a job in a bank. Eban Aguego Bank. EY. Here in OPM, God gave her a wonderful husband. Clap for Dr. Jesus.
While I was still rejoicing for that, God bless us with a child.
God give them belle. Clap for Dr. Jesus, everybody. Job, marriage, belle.
I was still thanking God for that. I never knew that he had a better package for me. Before I knew it, God blessed us with a land.
Clap for Dr. Jesus. Mirine.
I was still preparing to come and dedicate the land. We have built on the land. And today, I'm here to dedicate the land and the house.
Oh, you are moving to the house. Clap for Dr. Jesus, everybody. It's not granite. It's not biscuit. It is not kuli-kuli. It is not wisdom. It is power. Power. You are watching me on television. If church cannot change you, what do you do? I'm tired of hearing grammar. I'm tired of have faith. Have faith. Believe. Believe. Since you've been believing, since Adam bought 30 now, how far? Nida.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Chidi Ezefule. I'm from Amibo, Gwangele local government area of Imo State. I reside at number 3, way below street, in Ruboko. I located OPM when life was in shambles.
I came to OPM when life was in shambles, Nigeria Limited.
I was experiencing rising and falling. My situation was in fact highly precarious. But as I came to OPM, I picked assignments on financial restoration. On the 8th of October, 2014, God of OPM backed me up and I opened a school, which I testified here.
Clap for Dr. Jesus. I opened a school.
Not only that I opened a school, the God of OPM made my school very vibrant. Within a short while, people from nooks and crannies took my school. I rose up from zero to hero. Last year, here in this house, I dedicated my personal car and my school bus.
And my car and my school bus.
Today, I'm here to dedicate the 2 plots of land I bought here in Port Harcourt.
Once you come to OPM, your story must.
I can see him from afar.
Exodus 29, verse 45 to 46. And I will dwell among the children of Israel and will be their God.
God is here in totality.
God is here.
God is truly here.
God is indeed here.
Psalm 68, verse 16. This is the hill which God desireth to dwell in. Yea, the Lord will dwell in it forever.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here. God is here. God is here.
Him. Standing by the door with fire in his eyes and healing in his wings.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Victor Asukwo from Akwa Ibom State. I live at number 7 Patterson Street, Transamadi. In this OPM, I bought a car. Today, I want to dedicate my land.
In OPM, I dedicated my car. Now in OPM, I dedicated my land. OPM are buying the whole land in Port Harcourt.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Peace Ohaku. I'm from River State. I'm here to dedicate my land.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
My name is Mrs. Stella Tamogbembe. I'm from Okreka. I'm here to dedicate our land and our house that my husband be one story buildless.
One story building. Clap for Dr. Jesus, everybody. Once you come to OPM, you will build a house. Look at it. Who loses? Hey, well, look at it. Kisses. Staying upstairs. Neighbor, how are you? Nida.
PM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
I'm here to testify to the glory of God for his healing power in my life. My name is Divine James. Yesterday, I woke up with a sharp pain at my lower abdomen. So when my daddy came back with the anointing coconut that he brought from the night vigil.
We blessed coconut on the night vigil yesterday.
He gave it to me to eat and also drank the water. But first, he was thinking of taking me to the hospital before my mom now reminded him of the coconut. So as I ate the coconut and drank the water, I felt calmness all over my body, and suddenly I became healed. The pain just disappeared.
Clap for Dr. Jesus, everybody. Kneel down.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Emeka Nwosu. I am from Olu in Imo State. I stay at number 325 Roma Hall. My testimony is a mind-blowing one. I located OPM on the 6th of this month, May.
6th of this month?
May.
6th of this May?
Yes. After my sister has been persuading me to come here, I refuse because my life has been up and down. I have the grace of meeting anybody in this life, but I don't have result. I worked in the bank for 4 years. The moment I dropped, I resigned, they gave me promotion. So my life has been ups and down. So the moment I located OPM through television, I saw the man of God saying, if I be the man of God, your situation must change. So I said, enough is enough. I went to my wife's shop. I collected money. I didn't tell her where I was going to. I drove down to OPM. Unfortunately for me, they said, Daddy is not around. He traveled. But I didn't want to go empty-handed. I came to this place. I saw people doing mercy prayer. I packed some sands here, and I dropped my expectation, asking God to do it for me.
I packed sand here.
So immediately, 2 days later, I traveled to my village with my elder sister, Loretta. God will bless you for bringing me here. So immediately I went home. I was praying. The first night, after praying, my elder brother came and said, why are you praying? That people are afraid of you. Why are you praying? That they will think somebody is after you. I said, leave me alone. On the third day, after praying, because when I went home, I sprinkled the sand in the front of my father's gate. I said, So I said, God, please reveal that enemy in my father's house. And the saddest thing about betrayal is that the enemy is not the person you think it is. So on that third day, there was confusion and confession in my father's house. My uncle, whom we love so much, started confessing. He said, he is the person behind trying to destroy our family and ups and downs. I couldn't believe it. I said, these things I've been watching in TV. Before you know it, my elder brother came and started testifying, confessing that this is the man that wants to break the home, that he is sorry, that we are his strength, that he's not going to chase us out, that we are going to be brothers and sisters again. People were looking at me. So I give God that glory. So barely 7 days as I came back, many things begin to happen. I came back, my expectation that I told God in this altar, I told him that I don't want to buy land again. That the one I bought brought problem, although I settled it, that I want to buy a house.
Hey! God, I don't want to buy land again. The land I buy when I have money, problem. I want to buy a house. So, I've come to OPM, where wells they flow. I want to buy a house.
So, immediately I came back, 3 days later, I saw things changing.
Things changing.
To God be the glory, I bought a 3-bedroom flat in Ruma Hollow.
Remember, when he wanted to come to OPM, he went to his wife's shop to collect money. Now, he has bought a house. He only came this month. Hope deferred make the heart sick. He said, I will hasten my word to perfect it. That is God. God is not a wicked God. God don't keep on telling you, wait. Chige, chigabo, michewao, chi. Tell your neighbor, I am tired of waiting. Give Jesus a clap offering.
So the moment I gave that testimony, I shared it with my brothers. They said, this thing is the least thing they expected in life, that God is about to do more things in my life. But let them share their own testimony with me. That the moment I left, my elder brother that came from Abuja and witnessed what happened in the village, instantly they gave him promotion in FCDA.
Just because he went to his father's compound and poured, the evil man started confessing. Any evil man in your father's compound shall confess today in the name of Jesus. Look at the doors in the family, just popular. Him, doors open. His elder brother, appointment.
Then our first son, who is a lawyer, full of wisdom, that has been driving push and start, bought a Lexus Jeep.
He got
under 3 days.
Under 3 days.
Then, our last one that stays in Port Harcourt here called me 3 days ago to come and inspect a building he wants to buy. And by God's grace, on Tuesday, he's going to buy that building. It was not enough. My younger brother also called me that his boss called him in his office and told him and gave him recommendation and gave him promotion to choose any part of the country he has to go for training. I am giving this testimony to the glory of God. It's not a film trick. It's not a film trick. Me, I'm a Megan Wosu. I direct movie. I'm a Nollywood movie maker. But things has not worked for my life. But the moment I stepped here, my life changed automatically. Oh! So last week, I came here for mercy prayer. I met Daddy officially. He gave me on the assignment. And that assignment is what I'm doing now. Watch out for part two for what God will do for me.
Nido!
My name is Mrs. Edna Ibune. I located OPM on the month of March 2016.
Month of March 2016? Just 2 or 3 months ago.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
I'm here to return all glory, adoration, thanksgiving to God of OPM, who have given me a new life. Restore back my health. Remove morning cross from my family and clothed us with garments of victory. Everything started 2015 when I lost my husband on a motor accident. Everybody that had been eating in the same pot with us now turned against me and my children. I was depressed. I don't know where to run to. So I remembered one day I was going to Onitsha. I saw a signboard here. OPM, God in action. Dr. Jesus in action. So one day I now told my daughter that I will be coming to this place to see that Dr. Jesus in action. So that day after the service, I pick assignment. The first day I will start the assignment. My daughter now had a dream. She was praying in the dream, saying that I will not die, that I will not die, because I know that they have been pursuing me. Even that Sunday when I wanted to come here, one voice was telling me not to come, that if I enter cells, I will have that sentence and die. But I rejected it, I still come. So that early morning that I was supposed to start my mercy prayer, she was praying. When I woke up, I noticed that she was not sleeping, that she was sleeping. I was saying amen, amen, until when she woke up, she said that they show her morning certificate. Death certificate, they said that it's for her mother. That's when she started praying that I will not die. So that day, around 6 o'clock, I now started my mercy prayers. I urinated 1 hour interval from that 6 o'clock to 7 p.m. I don't know what was happening, but all I know is that I said that since I had met Dr. Jesus, that all the fissures in my body must leave me. So after the mercy prayer, during the time of 21 days midnight, I had a dream that a man placed something on my private part, something like plaster. That is when I started urinating every minute of the day. So I now called a doctor that sent me to test. After the test, they said that they did not see any serious thing, that the sugar is okay. So on the last starry night, I was here for the night vigil. I brought my coconut. So after the prayers and everything, when I reach home, I break the coconut, I drink the water and eat the coconut. Immediately, I noticed that something flushed out of my body. From that day till now, my health was restored. So I want to return to God, who has done
just
this.
Just after taking the water of coconut, everything vanished. Nina.
There's no one like you, Jesus. There's no one like you in all the end.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You've just listened to the testimonies. You've listened to the message. You are next to testify in the name of Jesus. But if you're not born again, I can lead you to Christ right now. Can you just lead the way right back? Lay on us. Let me pray with you. Repeat after me. Father Lord, I'm a sinner. I'm sorry. I promise not to go back to my old ways again in the name of Jesus. Now let me pray for you. Wonderful and great God, say that if my people that I call my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, they will hear from heaven and I'll forgive and say, I hear the Lord. Hear the Lord of children today in Jesus' name. Congratulations, you're not a new creature. All things have passed away and everything has become new. Now you can see me. You can come and pick assignment. You can come and see me by the grace of God. I'll give you assignment. The assignment is free. You're not paying anyone. In fact, if you go to any church and the pastor say, before you see the pastor, you pay money, that pastor happens to be an armed robber, he's a thief, he's a rogue. There is nowhere the Bible says, before you see any man of God, you pay money, or you fill form, or you do this express. So you can come and see me, and I'll give you a servant, and your story must change. In the name of Jesus. So call me on this number, and Dr. Jesus shall meet you at the point of your need, in Jesus' name.
See him from afar.
Exodus 29, verse 45 to 46. And I will dwell among the children of Israel and will be their God.
God is here in totality.
God is here.
God is truly here.
God is indeed here.
Psalm 68, verse 16. This is the hill which God desireth to dwell in. Yea, the Lord will dwell in it forever.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here. God is here. God is here.
Him standing by the door with fire in his eyes and him.